My name is Jonathan Denney, and I'm the co-founder and CTO at ConvertFlow. In this talk, I'm going to break down lessons learned scaling ConvertFlow on Postgres to 8+ billion events. So, who is this talk for? It's for CTOs and engineers at startups who want to learn not just from our wins at ConvertFlow, but also our mistakes on our journey through choosing a database, as well as scaling up our application and optimizing performance at scale. I'm going to break down each stage of our journey from 0 to 1 million events, from 1 to 100 million events, and then to billions of events. And for each stage, I'm distilling our learnings into lessons that you'll walk away with for you to use in your journey from choosing a database technology to scaling it up. So, what is ConvertFlow? ConvertFlow is a no-code platform for e-commerce marketing teams to create, personalize, and launch visitor conversion campaigns on their websites without waiting on developers. This means it's a SaaS application with thousands of paying users logging in to use a dashboard where customers create interactive content and experiments for their websites, which they're going to want to get insightful reports on. Now, this content our customers create for their websites gets viewed by as many as 40 million unique visitors per month at this point, which means a lot of events for our application to process and for our customers to report on. We launched ConvertFlow out of Techstars Chicago in 2016, which is a 3-month long startup accelerator with 10 companies per cohort. Now, since then, ConvertFlow has been installed on more than 20,000 websites serving brands such as Talkspace, Nectar Mattresses, and Volkswagen as customers. ConvertFlow has also reached 8.7 billion shopping events. It's reached millions in revenue, and this is all while staying lean and bootstrapping our growth. Best part, we've done all this while running on Postgres. So while I've got lots of CTO lessons that I've been learning in those early years of bootstrapping a SaaS company, you know, with limited time and limited capital, my goal here today is to offer a high-level overview of those lessons that relate to scaling our database. So let's get into it. Here's a story of how we scaled our database from zero tracked events to just 1 million events. So Techstars, summer 2016, we hadn't raised a seed round like many of the other companies in our cohort. So it was just my co-founder, Ethan, and I just hacking away at our MVP, you know, launch it quickly to validate demand for our product and to generate some early revenue. Now, at this stage, the common saying, premature optimization is the root of all evil, really applies. The highest leverage problems to be solving are not yet the technical problems a SaaS company will face post-traction, despite what developers like myself tend to want to believe. At this point, life or death of the company means choosing the right market, the right customer, solving the right problem for them, and solving it in a way that customers are actually going to pay for. This meant for our app stack, we needed to optimize for convention over configuration. Naturally, we chose Ruby on Rails to get started. And at this point, the Rails ecosystem was very developed. It was best practice to launch on Heroku because they made it so easy. And what was Heroku's flagship database offering? Postgres. Postgres was the perfect fit for us at this stage. It works great with Rails, which is the framework that we're most familiar with, and it was easy to set up on Heroku. Now, in our eyes, we thought we were just following Bootstrapper best practices, choosing Rails, the popular framework for startups at the time, Heroku, the cloud provider that was most popular for Rails at the time, and Postgres, which was Heroku's primary database offering. But the truth is, our time was almost entirely devoted to talking on the phone with potential customers, manually, you know, building solutions for their problems, finding the patterns in their demands, and then rendering all those learnings into a SaaS product that marketers and agencies would pay us their hard-earned dollars for. So with a handful of customers who were running their reports in the dashboard and less than 1 million events in our database, it meant queries were nearly instant. Scaling up our database at this early stage was very easy. We would get notified by Heroku that we were nearing our storage limit, and we would scale up. Optimizing queries against our events table was more a matter of creating the primary indexes that we needed, you know, to quickly query reports for specific customers and their individual ConvertFlow campaigns. So what are the lessons from this stage? So lesson number one, create the right product before worrying about scale. Once we found some early product market fit and started to see our app scaling up a bit, you know, we're generating some early revenue, Only then did we need to devote more time to optimizing our applications database for scale. So as you'll see throughout this talk, the tech stack decisions that we made were subject to change, and many of them did. But we were able to make those decisions as a result of real problems that arise using real data from live customer deployments, rather than spending time solving for hypotheticals. Now, this is especially important at the early stage, when most of your time and your attention should be invested with working with your customer to solve their problems and not on over-engineering your stack. All right, lesson number two. Because the objective at this stage is to learn which product to build as quickly as possible, the tech stack and database you choose should be easy to deploy live. It should be easy to reach some initial scale with. It should not cost an arm and a leg, and ideally it'd be open source in case you need to migrate vendors later on. Now, for our database, the answer was Postgres. However, if at this stage you're more familiar with another database technology that meets your criteria, possibly due to your past work experience, then by all means use your preferred database. Though if you're not sure, I suggest using Postgres because it's easy for early stage companies to set up. It's easy to deploy on today's cloud infrastructures. It's open source. It's got a great community. And what's great is it powers lots of companies operating at a massive scale. So you can stick with it long term. Okay. On to the next stage, scaling from 1 million events to 100 million events. At a million events process, we were confident that we had the stack that we needed to grow 100x. Well, we were wrong. As we landed a few larger brands with traffic totaling around 1 million monthly unique visitors, our customer-facing reports started to slow to a crawl. Customers started complaining about timeouts when viewing the reports, and slow performance notifications were filling up our inboxes. And simply scaling our Heroku Postgres database was just not solving the problem. Now, in hindsight, it wasn't working because as our events database grew, the amount of data that we needed to bring into memory for each query was far too large for a single node database. Of course, we didn't understand this. At this point, we had a burning problem that we needed to solve ASAP. Our app had become unacceptably slow for customers. We were landing larger websites with larger workloads each week. And that meant each day things were just growing more and more chaotic. So we started looking for other solutions. Now, shopping for an analytics database is really intimidating for an early stage startup. Each vendor we found online looked far too enterprise for a startup surviving on accelerator pre-seed capital. And using the cloud credits offered as perks with TechStars possibly meant configuring far too much on AWS, Azure, or Google Cloud than we had time for, with demo day approaching really soon. So we quickly figured out that our Google Cloud credits applied for Firebase. So in an attempt to put out the timeouts that we were seeing with our app, we started writing events to Firebase alongside of Postgres. Now, this is because we found that with Firebase, the queries were a little bit faster than we had at time, and it didn't cause the rest of the app to come to a halt each time one of our larger customers would run a report. So while this was less than an ideal solution, by writing and querying events to Firebase, we temporarily put out the fires. And we survived to the end of TechStars, and we had a successful demo. Okay, now on to the next stage, how we scale from 100 million events to a billion events. So at 100 million events, we thought our hack together stack of Postgres plus Firebase was ready to scale 10x or more. And once again, we were wrong. One day, I got this notification from Google Cloud that we were running out of credits. So I started poking around their dashboard to estimate what our costs are looking like. And let's just say the number made my heart drop once I saw it. Our Firebase solution had patched the problem, but we blew through our Google Cloud credits. And now we were facing a massive bill and unsustainable margins unless we found a long-term solution. Enter Citus, or Hyperscale Citus, as it's now called on Azure's platform. As we were facing imminent startup death by a Google Cloud bill that was coming next month because we ran out of our credits, I came across this article by Heap Analytics about how they scaled their Postgres database significantly using a Postgres extension called Citus. And it made it really easy for them to shard their analytics tables by a customer tenant ID column which resulted in much faster queries. Now, speaking about Heap analytics, I believe Matt Dupree at Heap is giving a talk at Citus Con right now as well. So make sure to check them out. Once we saw they were using Citus, and because we were already using Postgres, we were ready to drop Firebase in an instant. So I reached out to Citus, the Citus cloud team, and within a couple of weeks, with the help of Citus, we had migrated our Postgres database off of Heroku. We had sharded our analytics tables by website ID, and we had upgraded from a single node database to a cluster of nodes consisting of a coordinator node and multiple worker nodes. So what was the result? Our queries were about 2 to 4 times as fast as they were on our hacked together Firebase solution. And even more critical at the time, Citus Cloud's managed Postgres service was a far more predictable rate that we could actually afford while maintaining great margins for a SaaS company, which we had decided to continue to bootstrap to profitability at this point in time. Okay, time for a lessons recap. So lesson number 3, expect parts of your stack and your vendors to change with scale. So going from 1 million to 1 billion events was a really challenging time for us, but we were grateful to have a chance to solve problems that resulted from early product market fit. While we made some incorrect tech stack decisions along the way, without a doubt, because there was a strong demand from our customers and lots of really clear indicators driving our decision-making, we were able to adjust our stack based on real data and migrate to a vendor that was the right fit for us and that didn't break the bank. Okay, lesson number 4. We learned that scaling analytical workloads benefits from sharding tables by a customer tenant ID column and distributing the workload across multiple database nodes. Now, doing that's typically very hard for early stage startups, but Citus makes it really easy when running on Postgres. All right, on to the next stage. As we crossed 1 billion events, with our stack, you know, simplified, and our database optimizations now focused only on Postgres, we learned there were some other helpful optimizations we can make, you know, to keep the reports fast and so we could scale to billions of events. All right, so lesson number 5. The first low-hanging fruit was to adopt a roll-up strategy for our most commonly accessed reports in our dashboard. So by incrementing lifetime statistics for campaign views, conversions, and conversion rate reports, we could just fetch a pre-calculated report to visualize the totals for a customer's campaigns in a single page without having to make dozens of separate queries to the events table. And now we're taking this even further by incrementing daily statistics for each report. So visualizing a chart with stats for 30 days is reduced to adding up statistics from just 30 roll-up table rows rather than querying millions of individual events. Okay, lesson number 6. We started clearing out old stale data from hot storage. With the lifetime total statistics being recorded with our roll-up reports, we realized with the more granular reports, customers needed to see statistics for recent events, maybe up to a year or so. We realized we didn't need to keep historical event data in hot storage forever. So we started periodically clearing out event data no longer being frequently accessed. And what we found was this not only helped us optimize our margins because our storage needs were no longer growing exponentially, but our reports also became slightly faster because we were working with less data in hot storage. Okay, lesson number 7. The other major optimization we found was mitigating index bloat. Now, because Postgres versions introduced improvements to indexes over the years, we found that re-indexing our tables greatly reduced their storage impact, making maintenance operations easier and improving our margins a little bit. Now, when using Citus, re-indexing distributed tables happens a lot faster because each table shard re-indexes independently. Okay, now a caveat to look for when re-indexing production database tables. We're performing a re-index. Make sure to re-index the table concurrently. We learned this the hard way the first time we went to re-index a table without the concurrent part in the query added, which locked up one of our production tables for a short period that felt like an eternity. So as we scale to billions of events, it's not been without challenges, which brings us to lesson number 8. We eventually found that our events table ID primary key was going to hit the 2.1 billion max value limit of Postgres's integer column, which Rails used by default for ID primary keys at the time that we had created our tables. Now, we worked with Colton Shepard at Citus, who's also presenting at Citus Con now as a customer of Citus. So with his help, we strategized a minimal downtime migration to the Bigint Azure column type for our analytical tables primary keys. Now, how we did this within a 30-minute maintenance window is nicely documented on the Azure community site for your reference. Just search Citus ConvertFlow, and the article should come right up. So to offer a high-level insight of how we converted the ID column to Bigint Azure for billions of rows, we created a new Bigint Azure ID column. We indexed it, and then we backfilled values for the new Bigint Azure column with the same value as the original ID column. And then we switched over to the new column. The cutover time for this only took about 20 minutes, during which we held all incoming event requests in a big job queue to be processed after. So to dive deeper into this, Robert Treat has a presentation at this year's Citus Con that dives deeper into Bigint Azure conversions. So make sure to check that one out as well. Now, while we were making adjustments for this new stage of scale, Citus Cloud had been acquired by Microsoft, and it created a new offering on Azure called Hyperscale Citus. So in 2021, once again, we worked with the Citus team to migrate our Postgres database off of Citus Cloud's original AWS-based offering to Azure. And this was painless and done in just about 10 minutes. So they did this by streaming changes to a replica database on Azure and then having a switch over to the Azure connection string in a maintenance window that we had scheduled. Once we switched over to Azure, we had all the same features that we had with Citus Cloud's original managed Postgres service, along with the full support of the Azure platform. Okay, so here we are. So far, Postgres and Citus has supported us as we've processed 8.7 billion shopping events at the time of this talk. And with the new Hyperscale Citus offering in Azure, we could continue to scale out our database horizontally by adding more worker nodes as our customer base grows, meaning Postgres will support us for years to come. All right, let's recap all the top lessons for you to take away today. Lesson number one, in the beginning, don't worry about scale just yet. Focus on creating the right product. Your tech stack can change, you can migrate vendors in the future, but if you don't get early traction, there won't be a startup to solve scale challenges for. Lesson number two, we found that Postgres is a great database for startups to start with and to scale with. It's easy to work with, it's easy to deploy, it's got a great community, it's open source, and it's helped lots of companies reach a massive scale. Lesson number three, expect parts of your stack and your vendors to change with scale. As real data comes in, you'll have a crystal clear idea of what is and what is not a hypothetical problem. So that way you don't prematurely optimize too much. Lesson number four, when scaling applications with analytics on Postgres, sharding tables by customer ID and distributing the data across multiple database nodes is key for maintaining high performance at scale. The Citus Postgres extension makes this very easy, so I highly recommend that. Okay, lesson number five. To performance optimize frequently accessed reports, use rollup tables and incremented counts to pre-calculate statistics that display in your dashboard. All right, lesson number six. Clear out old, stale data that is infrequently accessed from hot storage. Lesson number seven, monitor your index bloat and re-index tables to reduce it. Also, make sure to re-index your tables concurrently. Otherwise, expect your table to lock up like ours did. All right, and then the last lesson here, lesson number eight, audit your tables for integer value limitations and migrate them to big integer before reaching the maximum value. At this point, there's documented cases of this kind of big integer conversion online, and you could find ours on the Azure community site if you search ConvertFlow Citus together. All right, so that's it. I hope these lessons serve you well as an early stage CTO or engineer, whether you are growing your applications on Postgres or not. And with that being said, if you're interested in building and scaling SaaS applications, come join us at ConvertFlow. We're hiring. If you have any questions, just drop a line in the CitusCon Discord. You could also reach me at Jonathan@ConvertFlow.com. Thank you so much.